In this video, I want to talk about MPEG-2 encoding on the Raspberry Pi 2. What I'm using here is OpenELEC 5.05. You can download this from the OpenELEC website. This is not the download from the Raspberry Pi website. But right now, I just have a standard build of OpenELEC, and I've set it up as a PVR client with a MythTV backend. And I'll put a link in the description to how to set this up, and I have other videos on setting up the Myth backend also, and I've have that set up right now. So first thing to demonstrate, I'm going to go to the TV and I'm going to tune to a TV channel in HD. And then I'm going to hit O, and this will tell us stats on the video that's playing right now. So right now we have an MPEG-2 video stream, and it's being decoded with the MPEG-2 video using FFmpeg. And you can see there are some dropped frames here. You also will note that this is a quad CPU processor. You'll see often that one of the processors will go to 100%. It's using a lot of processing power to display this video. And if the video with a lot of quick movement, it doesn't look very good either. So the Raspberry Pi 2 will display MPEG-2 video, just not very well. It's not the optimal way to view MPEG-2 video. So the solution to this is to purchase the MPEG-2 codec license, and that will allow you to use the hardware decoder in the Raspberry Pi. And this refers to the Raspberry Pi and the Raspberry Pi 2. Both have the codec license. And it's about $3 US dollars to buy that. So I'm going to walk through setting that up on the OpenELEC. So to get started, we'll need to enable SSH on the OpenELEC build. So we'll go into OpenELEC. We'll go to Services. And we'll enable OpenSSH. Okay, so it's restarted. Oops. And when you hover over this, you'll notice it says the username is root and the password is OpenELEC. I also have zero conf enabled, and that's enabled by default. So I'll use that to connect to the Raspberry Pi using the DNS name openelec.local. If you don't have zero conf enabled on your machine you're going to do the setup on, then you'll want to figure out the IP address of your OpenELEC box. So now I'm going to switch over to my Mac, and I'm going to log in with SSH, and we'll configure the MPEG-2 codec on this machine. So now I'm on my Mac, and you can do this on a PC or Linux box. On a PC, you're going to probably want to use an SSH client like PuTTY, or on Linux, you'll just use a terminal. So I'm going to open up a terminal, and I'm going to type in SSH root at openelec.local, and this is where you would type in your IP address if you aren't using zeroconf. I'll hit enter. Type yes, and I'm going to type OpenELEC as my password. So now I'll go down to the root directory, I'll type cd dot dot, and I'll look for the flash directory. And once we're in the flash directory, we'll see config.txt. Now if we try and edit this, you'll see that it's a read-only file. So to remedy that, we need to make it read-write. To do that, we'll type in mount /flash --0 remount, rw for read-write. Now I'll type in vi /flash /config.txt. And now this file is editable. So we'll scroll down until we find the section on the MPEG-2 codec. And it's right here. So in VI, to enter this, we'll have to type XX here to remove the comment. And I'll move my cursor to where the code goes, and I'll type XXXXXX. And then I'll type I for insert. And then I'll type in my code. Then I'll hit escape, colon, WQ. And that means write and quit. And that will exit us out. So now that that is edited, we'll type in reboot. And that will reboot the Raspberry Pi OpenELEC. And it will enable the MPEG-2 codec. I entered in a fake key there. I'll go back and enter the real key in, and then we'll head back over to the Raspberry Pi to see how it works. Now we're back on the Raspberry Pi. So go to TV, Channels. I'll tune into a channel. I'll hit O. And now you see it's using OMX MPEG-2. And you also notice that the CPU is not being taxed quite as much. Another thing you can do is plug in a USB DVD drive and place a DVD in it, and it will actually play on this XBMC with that. I've tried a couple discs and most of them worked, some of them did not work, but that was another feature, although I think most people would rather use a standalone DVD player. If you like this video, please click thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And if you want to see more of my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.